Hi guys, welcome back. Okay, today we're going to talk about the effects of cool gray. And I've got some tricks, and we're going to talk about why the trick works. Okay, so obviously I'm working on a big gigantic emerald ring. The combination for the green and the combination for the gold are going to be new. So stick around, I'm going to do some work on this. And then we're going to go back and examine exactly what I was doing. And I'm going to finish up the ring for you. So we will see you in a few minutes. Enjoy the video. And then we'll discuss what I did. You will find my color combinations in the description box. And I'll see you in a few minutes. Okay, so you watched this ring being developed and the emerald coming to life. Now, you would be very surprised, or, well, not by now, and by now you already know. I used some really different colors on the emerald to create a rich green, but I did not use a dark green. Let's go through the color theory on why this emerald worked the way it did. Okay, we have light green, which is more on the yellowish side or the whiter side. So you're adding blue and green, and then you're adding, of course, the white. Then we have apple green, which is a more yellow green than it is a blue green. I added, of course, white. And then I added cool gray, 90%. Now, why did this cool gray work? Because in theory, I'm using more yellows. So, all the beginning tutorials I've done, I've said to you, use cool colors with cool grays with cool colors, warm grays with warm colors. Yellow is a warm color, and here I am handing you a cool. Well, this is art, guys. You're meant to break the rules, and sometimes it just works. So let's talk about the theory behind it and why, in this case, it does work and work well. You've got in the cool gray, blue. So what I'm creating here is the yellow, the blue, and then we're going to take the black and handle that separately. So what I created here was we have the black going on to the green, which shades it, okay? Or another word for that would be toned. It toned the green and made it a darker shade of what the original color is. So the green, a darker shade of it would be the dark green. But because this has blue in it, emeralds are on the blue-green scale more than they are on the blue, more than they are on the yellow scale. The more it becomes a more expensive ring when the color is deeper and richer, and that's what you really want in expensive emeralds, is a really rich, dark green. So that's why this color works where you should have been using you, and you can. Okay, you can use warm gray on this. It's not going there. No one's gonna like bust down your door and say your emeralds are not worth anything. It's a very pretty stone too. But if you really want those rich stones, you add the cool gray. Now I have a new gold combination for you too in here. Instead of using the indigo blue, I use the same gold combinations that I do all the time. And that's canary yellow, goldenrod, and sienna brown. A lot of my gold combinations, and when I render gold, I use indigo blue. But instead of the indigo blue, what I did was I took the cool gray. Okay, even though it's with the yellow, I'm using the blue, just like the indigo. For whatever reason, the indigo blue works with gold. The cool gray is going to work with the gold because it does stem on the bluer side. So this combination varied up. Now, if I wanted, I'm trying to make a lighter gold than, say, my brassy gold, where I would use the sienna brown more. It's still the same four pencil combination, the white, the goldenrod, the sienna brown, and the canary yellow. It's the same four. But that next color, the one that you choose, and how much you use of each one will depict how your gold is going to come out. So I hope you understood. Now I'm going to finish up this ring and we'll see how it comes out at the end. Okay, I've taken this as far as I would like to take it right now. I have some ideas of what I want to do with this picture for later on down the road, so I'm going to leave it just the way it is for now, for a short amount of time. And I will see you guys in my next video. If you have any questions, just put it in the comment section below, or you can always write to me in private at my email address, which is listed in the description box. Keep on coloring, guys. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.